How to paint a watercolour galaxy, that's what this video is all about. I'll show you the whole process from start to finish all in real time. So, let's get them brushes wet. I'm Paul Hopkinson, an online art tutor, and welcome to my YouTube channel. Now you know I love showing my techniques for how to paint wildlife in watercolour. And here on my channel you'll find masses of free content. Now this tutorial is ideal for beginners, and also anybody that wants to have fun with their watercolour paints. And I'll take you step by step through the whole process. Now for even more fun and to keep you on your toes, look out for some shooting stars along the way throughout this video. Now these will point to even more information and to another full length real-time video tutorial for free here on YouTube. Now today I'm going to try and show you how to reproduce something like this kind of starry night sky, a little bit of a silhouette as well of mountainside. So how do we do that? First thing we need to do is get some watercolour paper. There you go. Now this is basic 140 pound cold press paper, and this particular one is made by Bockingford, which is one I use all the time. And I've used washi tape or masking tape, which is what this is here. Looks a low tap masking tape, and you get a variety of different designs on the market of these, which are quite useful. So all I've done, gone around the edge, and then obviously put extra strips in between, so we can have some extra little gaps, like a mini framework within the painting. Well, exactly what we've got here really, same kind of idea. Okay, so once you've got the masking tape on the paper, get your nail, just very lightly crease down where they overlap. And the reason why I tend to do that is because very often you find the paint will seep underneath in these little kind of splodge marks inside there. The brushes we'll be using today, these three here. I've got a size 1 inch mop brush, which is a very soft bristle brush, a size 5, and a size 00. So they're the ones I'll be using. And the paint in question, what's my point and stick, here we go. We've got alizarin crimson and phthalo blue on its own, okay. Mauve, which is a lovely color. And this one is Payne's gray and lamp black. And we will be using a little bit of watercolor white as well along the way. So remember that once you need some little white paint, either watercolor white or white gouache, it doesn't really matter. Okay. First thing to do, clean water, wet the paper. Here we go. Ready? Let's get stuck in. So, supposed to be clean water, this, it nearly is. I've been doing a little bit of practicing as well beforehand. But it doesn't matter. We've got quite a lot of colour going on here anyway. Now you need to wet this probably 2, maybe 3 times. So we're going to go ahead and do that now. Allow the water to soak into the paper though. The wetter the paper, the longer the working time that you'll have. Just allow it to soak in, as I say, so you can see kind of the nap of the paper, the texture of the paper showing through. Okay, well that should just about do. Now, as you can see on there, it's quite shiny, but it's not running down the paper like a waterfall, which is what we don't want it to do. So that's basically what we're looking for, something like that. The colour to begin with, we'll start off with, is phthalo blue. Now all these colours are mixed to more of a milky consistency, so not too thick. Okay, we don't want to go too thick too quick. If we need to thicken them, we can do. So start applying this to the paper first of all. I'm going to go forwards, well, more towards the middle area, and I'm going to work in that sort of direction really with this. Don't want it too dark. A little bit down there as well. And then I'm going to go into the mauve. I'm not going to bother washing the brush though. I know, terrible. Should wash the brush really. I do normally. So a little bit of mauve, intermingled with the blue. Lovely colour that, isn't it? Said that before. Bring it into that blue area. A little more on this side now. This is why you need this paper to be quite wet. Because if it's not wet enough, you find it will start to dry on you. When it starts to dry on you, it will leave little cauliflower marks and little marks all over the paper, which you don't want it to do really. A little bit of phthalo blue around there, just so it purples it down a little bit more there. Back to the mauve. Okay, coming down to the bottom there. I'll get down to the bottom in a minute, because the only thing is, where you last wetted it will stay wetter longer, if you know what I mean. So, say for example, I wetted up here first of all when I wetted the paper, and then I finished down there. This side will most likely dry quicker than this side, but a little bit of this colour in the top now. So this has got that alizarin crimson in it. So phthalo blue, alizarin crimson, bring a few little strikes here and there into towards the middle. Just a few here and there. Then we're going to come all the way down to the bottom, back to the mauve colour. Just fill this area in now with mauve, just for now anyway. Yeah, this is definitely wetter down here because obviously the water runs down that paper. So I've got my board on that slight angle like that. Now then, a little bit more of the alizarin crimson and phthalo blue just down this side here. And I'm going to go in with the lamp black and the Payne's grey. Just to darken, just parts of the corners, skipping places here and there. So we've got a slightly darker mix in there at the same time. And I think that will just about do. Now, when the paper starts to dry, it starts to go off, then you find that's when you want to leave it. Let it dry on its own then, or give it a quick blast from a distance with a hairdryer. But if you get any runs like this all puddling up, use a nearly dry brush and just very lightly touch and lift it. The same there, not a bit too dark there. But we're going to darken all this area down here anyway, I know. But just for now. Other than that, get some kitchen roll like that there, so it's nicely folded. Okay. And I'm going to very lightly take off the paint on top of the masking tape. And down there as well. A little bit down there. Try not to touch the painting. Then choose another area. There we go. And very carefully you can take off towards the middle. You won't be able to get right to the edge, but just be careful with this, as I said, if you do decide to do this. The reason why I do this is because it just helps me want to take the tape off later on. And if the tape is still a little bit wet in places, it's going to stay wetter longer, like we said about wetting the paper. But you won't be able to get really close to the edges because obviously you'll end up going onto the main painting. So just be careful not to do that. And other than that, just got to give it a chance to dry. Or as I mentioned, quick blast with a hairdryer. From a distance, of course, though. Now that's nice and dry. Excellent. I'm going to go for the watercolour white next. I'm going to make sure I've got this to more of a kind of milky consistency, nearly creamy. As I said earlier on, you can use white gouache. It's very similar indeed. So anything water-based really you can use. So some water down there first of all. I want to get my old mixing brush. This is an old acrylic brush, painting brush, but I use it for mixing the watercolours now as it's so old. And I want this more to a, say, like a milky cum creamy sort of mixture. And I'm gonna, this is the fun part really as well. It's all fun part, isn't it? Gonna load this brush up. So it's a stiff bristled brush. Okay, and here we go. I'm going to start to flick some white spots all over the sky. Just kind of represent stars really, more than anything. And this is where you find you get it all over your painting table and desk, which I always do. So some bigger splodges if we can. There we go, something like that. Bring it all the way down. Make sure you get these edge strips as well. And then if you want to, you can concentrate. This is very filthy, isn't it? You know, my finger's covered in paint here. You can concentrate on one little area like here. I'm going to do like a galaxy coming down. All the way down the paper. And the more you go over the area, the whiter it will be. All the way down the paper there. Alright, reload. Let's do a few more. Probably around there. And I think I'm going to make my galaxy even whiter. All about splattering paint, that's all it's about. A few more down the side, a few more down that side. Go on, that'll do. Okay, give that brush a good wash out. And then what you need to do, wash your finger as well. Make sure that's not completely full of paint. You don't want that everywhere, do you? And this is where we start to add the black. Okay, so first of all, I'm going to go for, tell you what we'll do, we'll go for the size 5 again. So this is that Payne's grey and lamp black, okay. And I'm going to start adding this more towards... Let's have a look. Well, I don't know. Let's go there. It's our painting. We can do whatever we want with it. I'm going to put a line probably around here, scumbling down. Make up a shape as you go along. Let's have some more. If I run out of this colour, it's easy enough to make up again, isn't it? And then fill in so far, probably about an inch or so. Something like that will do. This is why this paper's got to be nice and dry when you do this, because the next stage involves wetting it down. So I'm going to add a line of water around there. I'm not worried if it moves any of the paint on the paper to that degree, because they're going to be quite dark in places, really well. And I'm going to tickle that in, little circles. Well, actually, these are quite big circles, aren't they? Tickle it into that area down there and bring it down. Okay, keep bringing that line down just to somewhere like that. And then we need to dry it again. So we can take some paint off that masking tape. There you go. So we'll give it another quick dry and then we'll add another line of mountainside as well. Okay, well that's just about dry. So now we can have another line down there as well. So let's start probably around here. And bring that down, scumble it around. Whoa, let's go uphill again. No, let's come back down again. Wherever you want it to go, it's entirely your choice. It's your mountain. And probably around there as well. I may even just bring one just coming down into there. Why not? I'm going to wet this down, probably around there. And then, again, water down below. Again, my water isn't that clean again. That's the only problem when using a very dark colour, especially black. Your water does get filthy quite quickly, it really does. Allow that to blend into that water. In fact, here's what I'm going to do. I'm not happy with that. I'm going to bring that even higher. I need a nice kind of variation within these mountains. A little bit higher. I'll play with it as I go along. Okay, so we'll dry it again and we'll put another mountain down below. Okay, well that's dry enough at the moment. It's not quite dry, but it's dry enough down here, which then means we can carry on. Let's start on this side now, shall we? Let's bring one down that way. So that's another layer. You have to remember watercolour as well. Every layer of paint that you add on, the darker that layer will get. And that also applies to these really, really dark layers. So I'm going to just fill this area in now. Might come down actually higher than that. Why not? A little bit higher. There you go. And bring that all the way down to the bottom. Add that one in there. That's better look. I've got paint again. And it's down the bottom. Fill it all in. Okay, now this does need to dry, but before we leave that to dry, I'm going to add another little effect. Put some little birds in the sky. Now these birds, I think, was it the great Bob Ross? He used to call them M birds. So we're going to do something very similar. We're going to have some little birds around here. That's a little tiny dot first, then a line coming away like that. A line going down towards it. If you want to do one flicking away, you can do. There's one. Let's put one at a slight angle further up there. That one's on its side. Let's have one down there. Okay. And I might even put one right at the top there out of the way. Just coming into the shot there. There you go. And I think that will just about do there. Now, give it a chance to dry and we shall then remove that masking tape. Okay, here we go. Time to take that masking tape off. So you can take it off in all in one go if you want to, but I like to do it carefully and gradually. So remembering what goes over what, really, to be honest with you. So I'm just going to take that one off there to begin with a lot, to reveal one line. Now then, what else we got? Where does that one go? So we'll take that one off there. Now, I'm not trying to pull off at an angle or anything like that, which is the way I would normally do that with masking tape. And that's only because if this does tear the paper, we want to make sure it tears towards the white of the paper, not in towards that lovely background we just applied on there. So we can take that off there. Then this one, which is that one. There you go, that's easier. And then the rest. And there you go. That's how to paint a very starry night sky silhouette kind of hillside. It's quite an interesting one to do, isn't it? It's fun to do as well. Especially kind of working with these borders and the masking tape at the same time. And don't forget, you can create whatever image you want to. You can have wildlife in there. Entirely your choice. So until next time around, I'm going to say one last thing. Keep them bushes wet. Bye for now.